So hi everyone. So today in this class, all the exercises which are present in the previous class, we learned about how to draw the pattern and how to find out the triangular numbers and how to find out the sum of the present the numbers or how we can represent the pattern in terms of the square numbers. So now in this exercise, we have to use all the data what we learned in the previous classes. Okay, so just like what is the end digit or last digit of perfect square, or if a certain number is given, we have to find out whether this number is a perfect square or not. Or by using the pattern, we have to find out the missing terms. So like many questions are here, and I will solve the first one, that is what will be the unit digit of the square of the following numbers. What will be the, so exercise 2, it is 6.1. okay, so in the old textbook, that is second exercise, but in the new textbook it is 6.1. now so I will write the question, what will be the unit digit. First mean unit digit of unit digit of square. Unit digit of square. So now we have to find out what will be the unit digit and by using the known data, we have to find out the end digit. So in the introductory class, we learned that 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, then 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, then 5 square is 25, 6 square is 36, then 7 square is 49, 8 square 64, 9 square 81. 10 square. Just check once again whether the square, the value is squares. Now the first question is 81. Now we have to find out what is the unit place. Unit place is last number. Okay, so for example, we mark the back. So this is unit place. This is the 10. And this is 100. Okay, this is 10. This is unit. That means 1. So now, so they gave as a number, and now we have to find out what is the unit place of the square. Okay, unit place of the square. So this is our tabulation. So here end digit is 1, 4. Okay, I'll write down here. End digits are 1, then next one is 4, then 9, then next one is 6, then next one is 5, then 6 is repeated, 9 is repeated, 4 is repeated, 1, then last one is 3. So that means if any number is given and if you want to find out the unit digit or the last digit of the square term, then we have to see terms. Okay, see this number. Whether in the unit place, for example, 1 is there, we have to square the last digit. Only we have to square the last digit. So 1 square is 1. So therefore, unit digit of 81 square. Unit digit of 81 square is 1. Unit digit of 81 square is 1. What is the reason? Because unit digit of the given number is how much? Given number is 81 and unit digit is 1 and square of 1 or square of 1 is 1. That, okay, so this is the reason. Therefore, the unit digit of 81 square is also 1. We have to remember. So I will check also 81. 81 into 81. I will verify this whether it will give the unit digit as 1 or not. 1 into 1, 1. 1 into 8, 8. Plus 8 into 1, 8. 8 is a 64. 1, 8 into 16, 1, 4 plus 1, 5, then 6. So what is the unit digit? Unit digit is again 1. Therefore, we have to, if any value is given, we have to see the unit digit. We have to square that term directly. We have to square that term, and that term gives the unit place. Okay, I will not write a statement for the next questions. Okay, so you have to copy this for all the terms. You have to change the number and unit place of the given number. And I'll write only the answers. The second one is 278. 278. So I will write this as 1. Okay, no need to write square because in the question it is given that the square of 7. So 2. Now what we have to find out? Square. If not, you can write. Okay. Then here also you can write square. So we have to consider the unit place of given number. Given number is 2 here and 2 square, that is 4. And it contains a single number 4. So therefore, this also unit place is 4. Okay, so then next one, I will consider the third one. So third one is 799. So 799, what we have to consider? We have to consider the last digit. Last is 9. 9 square we have to find. So 9 square is, see here, 9 square is 81. And what is the last digit here? 1. So that will be the answer to answer as 1. Okay, these are our unit digits of the square. Then fourth one I have to consider. Fourth one is 3853. 3853. Now, this is for your work. Find out what is the unit place of square of this number. Now tell me what is the unit place of this square. So, write the answer in the comment box first. Yes, correct. So, 3. We have to consider 3 and 3 square is 9, that is single number. So therefore 3853 square unit place is 9. Okay, 3853 square's unit place is 9 because the unit place of the given number is 3 and square of 3 is 9. So therefore 3853 square's end term or the last digit or unit place is 9. Then fifth one, so you have to work out fast. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now tell me what is the unit place for 1, 2, 3, 4 square. 1,234 square unit place is dash. First, these are all unit place of the squares. Yes, what we have to consider? We have to consider last digit, that is 4, and 4 square is 16. So, we consider 16, see here, 4 square is 16, and the last digit is, or the unit digit is 6. So, therefore, square of this number also contains the end digit as 6. Okay, you have to write the statement because they will ask to find out the unit place as well as they will tell. So if they ask what is the reason behind that, so then you have to explain that. Okay, for the first problem, I give the wordings and you have to copy and you have to change the numbers. Now the next one, sixth one, 2 26387 7 2 6 3 8 7 2 6 3 8 7 2. Now find out answer. First, what are the days of this square of this number?
Comment fast.
Yes, correct. 7 is given in place. 7 square is 49 and last digit is 9. Correct? Then next one. See here. 141969. The numbers are not 2 or not 7, and it contains only the square of the numbers, contains only these many terms, 1, 4, 9, 6, 5, except that no other terms will contain. Okay, so I have this. Then the next one, I will write all the remaining questions here. 5, 2, 6, 9, 8, 5. This is 7 1. Then 8 1. So solve fast. 9 9 8 8 8 0 square. Then 9 1. 1 2 7 9 6 square. Then 10 1. 5 5 5 5 5 square. So this is for your unit place of square. Unit place of square. So comment me fast. Which are the units of the given square numbers? Which are the unit place of given square numbers? So consider the first one, 7th one. What is the answer? What is the answer of 5269 square? So what is the unit place? So your last number is 8. 8 square is here. 8 square is 64, and the 64's last digit is 4. So that unit place is 4. Correct? Yes, your answer is correct. The next one, 9980 square. So 0 square, it is 0 only. So then 0. Then 6 square. So 6 square is 36, see here, 6 square is 36, and unit place is 6 here. And next one is 5 is the unit place of the given number, and 5 square is 25, and the last one is 5. So this is the method to solve or to find out the unit place of square of the given number. Okay, so very simple. So for all the questions, you have to write the statement. So now the second thing is, the following numbers are obviously not perfect square. Give reason. The following numbers are obviously not perfect square. They gave many numbers, only 8 numbers they gave, and they told that the given numbers are not perfect square. We have to write the reason for why they are not perfect square. We have to write that statement for them. So they gave the numbers and they alerted that they are not perfect. Now we have to give the reason for it. So I will write the first question. Reason. Give reason. The first one, 1057. 1057. So this is the given number. 1057 is not a perfect square. And what is the reason behind this? The unit place is 7. Unit place or unit digit as you can consider. Unit place of given number. Given number is, what is the unit place here? Given number is 7. Given number is 7. You can write this in denominator comma. but perfect squares, perfect squares unit place, unit place contains only, so which is the numbers 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, 9. 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, 9. So read the statements again. Unit place of given number is 7. Yes, 1057 is the given number and unit place is 7. But perfect squares unit place contains only the last bits as 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, 9. Except if any number is given, for example, 1558. So then it is not a perfect square because the end digit is 8. So if the end digit is 9 or 6 then or 5 or 4 or 0, then we can tell that that may be the perfect square. Okay. So this is the reason for this. For all the questions, you have to write down. Copy the same reason, only you have to change the end digit. Okay, you have to change the end digit. Then the second reason.
Square of which number is odd? So we have to write the
we have to choose which number is odd. So first one is 4, 3, 1. Then second one is 2, 8, 2, 6. Third one is 7, 7, 7, 9. And fourth one is 8, 2, 0, 0. So now, what the given number is, the square of which of the following would be odd number. Okay, odd number we have to find. So, same process, just like the first main. So, this is the unit place. Unit place is 1, and 1 square is 1, and 1 is odd. Yes, this is odd. You have to write the reason. Okay, you have to write the same thing. The square of the given number or the unit place of given number is odd. Okay, then 2826. 6, here 6 square is 36. And last will be 6, that is even. Then 9 is a 21. Last is 1, that is odd. And next one is 4. 4 square is 16 and 6 is even. Even number. Okay, so this is about how to find out the unit place of the given numbers. Now we have to go for the patterns. So some patterns are given, and by knowing that patterns method, we have to write the missing terms in the given pattern. Okay, so listen carefully. So I have got the square values also. So first one is observe the following pattern and find the missing digits. Okay, 4, 8. Find the missing digits. So the values are given 11 square. 11 square is 1, 2, 1. The next 101 square, that is 1, 0, 2, 0, 1. The next one is 1, 0, 0, 1 square, that is equals to 1, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 1. Now what we have to find out? We have to find the missing terms of the numbers 1, 0, 2, 3, 4 square. We are finding the missing terms, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 square. We have to find out the missing terms. So here 1 is given, then 2 is given, then again 1 is given. All these are blank terms. And similarly, so in the next one, they not give the values. We have to find out the terms which are present in this. So, two terms are present, that will be considered 2, 2, then 1, 1, then 1, 0, 1, 2 1s are present. Okay, so this is the simple trick to solve this. 2 1s are present, so that means we have to get 2, but here 1, 0 is given. So therefore, in front of 1, we have to put 0, then totally how many 1s are present? 2 1s are present, therefore it is 2, then again 0 and 2. Okay, so we have to draw the same pattern. The next one, so just like I said, we solve this pattern 1, then 1, 2, 1, then 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. So like this pattern. Okay, the left hand side is the same as the right hand side. That is just like the reflection. Just like reflection. So now, here,
that will be 1, 2, 3.
And similarly on the right hand side, I will have 1, 2, 3. Okay, see here, two zeros, two zeros. 1 0, 1 0. Here they not given any zeros, therefore I am not putting any zero. Here they give 3 zeros, therefore here I have the 3 zeros on the left hand side as well as on the right hand side of. Next one, 1 2 3 4 5 6. 6 zeros are present. Now tell me the answer. Come in. So if you understood from first to fourth one, you will write the answer for the fifth one. So comment me first. What is the ones present in the pattern? First, so 1 2 3 4 5 6. So 1 1 it contains 2 ones. That's at the center. I will write 2. Then 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 zeros are present. What I have to do? I have to write 6 zeros on the left hand side as well as 6 zeros on the right hand side. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Then similarly on the right hand. 1 2 3 4 5 6. And the starting one and at the end you have to write 1. Okay, these are the missing terms present in the pattern. These are the missing terms or missing digits present in the pattern. One is simple one. Now the next one. I think you understood this. The next one. Observe the following pattern and supply the missing numbers. That means again we have to add the missing terms which are present in the given question. Okay, missing numbers. Find the missing numbers. Find the missing numbers. Again we give some pattern and we have to analyze that pattern. Then 0, then then 2, then 0, then 1. Then see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 1 are present. That means at the center, what I will write? I will write 4. At the center, totally 4 1s are present. Therefore, at the center, I will write 4. Then, what is the remaining here? So, after 4, it turns 3, then 2, then 1. But, alternate zeros are present. Okay, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Like is present. So, therefore, we are writing here 0. The next one is 0 and 3. Then we are writing 0, then 1. Okay. 4, 0, 3, 0, 2, 0, 1. Inner reflection. So then after 4, 1, 0. Then the next lower digit is 3. Then again 0. Next lower digit is 2. Again 0. Then 1. Okay. I think you understood this. Now, comment.
So find out what is the missing term on the left hand side. Just look at the patterns or 4 patterns which are given above, and by using that, so write the left hand side of the
given. So 1 2 3 4 5 4 3 2 1, what is the, which is the highest? 3 4 4 ones are present. Let me set the center 0 4. Here 1 2 3 3 ones are present, left at the center 0 3. Here 1 0 1, 2 1s are present, therefore 2. Here 2 1s are present, therefore 2. But here we have to do the vice versa process. So that means reverse process we have to do. Here at the center 5 is given, that means 5. At the center 4 is present, that means in the left hand side contains 4 1s, in the center it contains 3.
Very simple one.
The next pattern. Again, we are not subscribed. Subscribe the channel fast and press the bell icon for the new notification of the classes. Then using the given pattern, find the missing number using the given pattern. Again, 6 1. Find the missing numbers. Find the missing numbers. So I will write the pattern here. 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square, that is equals to 3 square plus 6 square, that is equals to 7 square. Then 3 square plus 4 square plus 12 square, that is equals to 13 square. So the next one is 4 square plus 5 square plus dash. Square is given, and on the left hand side we give 21 square. Then 5 square plus 6 square plus 30 square, that is equals to, they give 31 square. Then the last one is 6 square plus 7 square plus dash square, that is equals to dash. Just look at the questions which are given in the
board and try to understand something what you can understand.
So this is very interesting pattern. Okay, you can solve this by one method, but that is not perfect method. So here 2 is present, next it is 3. 3, here 6 is present, next digit is 7, here 12 is present, next digit is 13, here 21 is present, that means the previous one is 20, here 31 is present, previous one is 30, but here we will not get any numbers from the left hand side as well as right hand side. So then the number idea is flawed. Okay, so what you understood from this? 2, after that 3, 6, 7, 12, 13, then 21 means it is 20, 31, 30 or 37. Then here you are not able to write the missing term. So for that there is one simple method. So I'll tell you, so listen carefully. 1, so just neglect the square terms for time being. Okay, just neglect the square terms for time being. Only consider the terms. 1, 2, 1, 2 is 2. 1 into 2 how much? 2. Then 2 and 3. The first two digits are 2 and next one 3. 3 2 is how much? 6. The next digit is 3, 4. 3 into 4. 3, 4 is how much? 12. Yes, our answer is correct. It gives again 12. So these are 3 patterns. And now I told you the method. How to find the missing term. Now, I will comment me first.
Comment fast. Which are the missing terms here? Which are the missing terms present here?
So again, the first four digits are 4 and 5. We have to multiply that. 4 into 5. 4, 5. Okay, 4, 5 is 20. And then again, we have to find out the missing term here. The first digit is 5 into dash and the next answer is 30. Now, 5 into dash equals 30. So that we can write that 30 divided by 5. 35. 30 divided by 5 is 6. 6 to 5 is 30. So that we can write 6. 6 5. 5 is 6 is how much? 30. The next one is 30. Then here 6 and 7. 6 and 7. 6 7 is 42. So that here I have to write 42 square. Then same what we followed at the beginning. 42 next one is 43. Okay, that method also that is useful, but to find out the first term or to find out the second term, we have to use this method, that is multiplication method. Okay, so 1 2 is 2, 2 3 is 6, 3 4 is 12, 4 5 is 20, 5 is 30, 6 7 is 42, and here we have to increase one number. 2 plus 1, 3, 6 plus 1, 7, 12 plus 13, 20 plus 1, 21, 30 plus 1, 31, 42 plus 1, 40. So I think you understood this. Then the next thing, you have to find out the numbers without adding. We have to find the numbers without adding. Without adding, find the sum. Without adding, find the sum. The numbers are first one, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. That is equals to. Then second one is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 19, that is equals to Then the third one, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15, 17 plus 19, 21 plus 23. Now we have to write the sum without adding. So very simple. All the odd numbers are given here. We have to count how many odd numbers are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 odd numbers are. For this, that is n square. N square. So 5 odd numbers are present, therefore it is 5 square. And 5 square value is 25. So we have to count how many odd numbers are present and we have to square that. 5 square becomes 25. Just by using this method, so find out and comment for the next question. Yes, coming really fast. So the second one is 13 up to 19. Now we have to count how many numbers are present, how many odd numbers are present in this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 odd numbers are present. 10 odd numbers are present, that means it is 10 square. And
comment fast.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 terms are, or 12 odd numbers are. That means 12 square. And 12 square value is 144. I think you understood this as your answers are correct. Then, next way.
Odd numbers we have to write
and we have to represent 121 as sum of 11 odd numbers. So starting from 1 + 3 + 5 + 7 + 9 + 11 + 13 + 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. Okay, 11 odd numbers. So this is the method to express the odd numbers. The given number as sum of the odd numbers. Last, how many numbers lies between? How many numbers lies between the given numbers? First one is 12 and 13. Then second one is 25 and 26. So in the previous class I told you about this. Now just recall that and comment me the answer first. So what we have to write? So this is 12 and this is 13. It is n term. It is n plus 1 term. How many numbers lies between the given number, the given square of the number? Numbers lies between square, okay, I have right here, square of given numbers. So here 12 is n, we have to consider, and we have to consider 13 as n plus 1. Okay, so n square and n plus 1 square. How many numbers are present? 2 n numbers are present. 2 into n values 12 here, 12 is the 24. So totally 24 numbers. 24 numbers are present between 12 square and 13. So now 25 and 26. 2n. 2 into n values 25. 25 into 2, 50. Therefore, 50 numbers are present between 25 square and 26 square. 99 and 100, 2 into 99, 198. Therefore, 198 numbers are present between 99 square and 100. Okay, I think you understood this. Very simple trick.
Thank you everyone. If you not subscribe, subscribe now.